first of all, आप मुझे बोलो, how do you feel? What's your feeling right now?
My feeling is that of joy and accomplishment. One, on the mere fact that we are alive. Two, we have not given up on hope. Three, we are connecting across borders. So, technology can scare us when we don't know it, but then it helps us connect with each other across distance. So that it's joy, and also you've not given up on me despite all the technical hassles.
ये कोइंसिडेंट के बारे में कुछ बोलो, कैसा फील हो रहा है? ये जो यू आर इन येलो, आई एम इन येलो, यू नो पीपल आर गोना थिंक दैट वी प्लान्ड दिस.
सी, आई थिंक इंडिया एंड बांग्लादेश दे वर जस्ट लेटर ऑन मेड इन टू टू, दे वर वन ओनली, नो. सो सच कोइंसिडेंसेस आर बाउंड टू हैपन, लाइक दिस जस्ट सी. ऑल्सो आई वाज रीडिंग शैडोवाइज, वन ऑफ द नॉवेल्स आई रियली एंजॉयड रीडिंग. And then one of the kids discovers, was reading something about Dhaka, and asks, the kid's grandmother asks him, are the people same there in Dhaka? Aren't they different? Someone told me their feet are like this and things like that. And the kid is like, no Dadi, they are the same. So, you know, political borders are silly things. People are the same. So I think this coincidence is a marker of how similar people are.
One quick question. If you ever get an opportunity to do a Bengali film, language is going to be Bangla, are you going to be interested?
Geetika, today you do not give. We have this distance between us, but you did not give up despite the technical things that I needed to learn. Because I'm doing this for the first time. You know, all of this and all of this I'm doing for the first time. You cooperated. Mm. And I was excited to accomplish something new, you know, because new territories, new explorations. So similarly, I mean, Bengali is, there are a lot of Shuddha Hindi words in Bengali. Also, like if you are familiar with Sanskrit, a lot of North Indian languages you can understand. So like Bhishan.
Yeah.
Bhishan is very, you know, you look Bhishan pretty today.
Wow, you know. So how did you know? But what do you mean? Bhishan is also, it's not Hindi.
Hindi, in Hindi, Bhishan means extreme.
Bhishan.
Yeah, Bhishan. Bhishan. Oh, so Bhishan again in Bengali, Bangla is
extreme. Huh.
So that way, because I know Sanskrit, I can make meanings of a lot of words that have North Indian, or let's say anything that's not Dravidian in India is ends up making some sense to me because of the Sanskrit roots. So I'm sure I'll pick things up really fast, and provided the script is interesting, I would want to do it. I also believe that language stops becoming a barrier if you are emoting what needs to be emoted. So, ho jayega. Inshallah, I'll be able to do that also.
Oh, now you already got this from me, right? Last 1 week, har baat pe. Inshallah.
You have actually invoked it's like a habit. This again. A number of my friends have this habit. So one of these films I was shooting for before the lockdown started, and my co-actor Pavan Malhotra, he's in India, he's one of the renowned veteran actors. Saleem Langde Pe Matro was his very famous film. Whatever will happen, like, Ya Allah, and be like, will you let Allah rest, or will you just keep on invoking him? And I was like, why are you changing territories? You know, he's like, Arey, Bhagwan bhi mera hai, Allah bhi mera hai. So that way is like, and one of the artists who helped us construct the house, he built our temple. He's a Muslim karigar. And that day he came, because of Corona, he said, Main toh Bhagwan ko kehta hoon, mujhe bacha le. And I was like, Manwar bhaiya, aap Bhagwan ko kehte ho, are you sure? So that way I think we have, like in India, Bangladesh, we call we call Badi Mummy. You know, mothers, the wife to father's elder brother. So instead of calling her aunt, we call her badi mummy, choti mummy. So that way, when we can exchange mothers and fathers, we can exchange languages and words and gods also. All of that is just like sources of solace, really, na?
Where did you grow up? I want to know that first.
I grew up in Sonipat, where I am sitting right now. This house where I'm sitting. I wasn't born in this house. I was born in the hospital. And for the initial 1 year of my life, I was at my paternal grandparents' house. Then I was brought to my maternal grandparents' house, to my Nana Nani, which is maternal grandfather, grandmother, in Sonipat, Haryana. That's where I was brought up. I did my schooling from here. And this state, this city in the state of Haryana, is on the northern border of Delhi, which is the capital city of India, which also is a house to the biggest university in, one of the biggest universities in India, that is University of Delhi, Delhi University. From there, I did my graduation and master's in English literature. During my graduation and master's in English literature, I started theater. I wrote, like, my first initiation in theater was being a part of street theater, which was being revived. So last year's place, from which seniors had left, there were some places vacant. Some juniors were allowed to step in. So you become a part of a street play. The next year, later in the year, you become a part of the cast of a new street play, where not only are you acting, you're also a part of script writing with your directors. In the second year, I was directing a street play. I co-directed and co-wrote a street play, which also is I was made into one of the documentary protagonists by a senior. And that documentary is called Izzat Nagri Ki Asabhya Betiyan, Immoral Daughters in the Land of Honor. That's available on YouTube. So my that little journey, it is available on YouTube. That little journey is archived in Izzat Nagri Ki Asabhya Betiyan. After which, third year was stage theater, not direction, acting in it, acting in a number of them. After which I started my master's and working as a professional actor with Zangura, which was India's first Bollywood musical theatre. So it had more than 80 dancers dancing.
Which year was it?
This year I was a part of this Bollywood. No, it is not a musical film. It is India's first Bollywood musical theatre. So it was called India's counterpart to the Western sub-Broadway. So it was live theater. It happens still today. It happens still today.
It happens in Delhi.
It happens in Gurgaon, which is in Haryana, but on the border of Delhi. So it's one of the most glamorous stage performances that happens in India, I think, till. Later on, more of them came up. Now, I guess it's 10 years old. Now it is 10 years old. I was a part of it for 3 years. So after that.
And you were doing some plays. You were also directing, you know, the street plays. And of course, you were in university. How did Sony come to you? Like, how did you, what was your experience like? Were you auditioned for it? Did you audition for it or... Yeah, so share with us a little bit of that story.
Before Sony, no one had seen me on screen because I had not acted on screen. You know, so one of my immediately after graduation, when I joined Kingdom of Dreams and when I started my master's, a number of people with good intentions would say, "Why aren't you going to Bombay if you want to be an actor?" You know. You shouldn't go to Bombay after 25, that'll be too late. You won't be as young as an actress should be. Or you will be too educated to be an actress. And I was like, you know, being too old to be to be desirable or being too educated to be desirable are two things that have been told to women since ages.
Mm.
And the same things were being told to me by people who had heard the same things, but never happened to them to question. So why am I saying all of that? While I finished my graduation and started master's and my job in Kingdom of Dreams, I actually somewhere in my life was educating myself enough to feel secure in my own self, so that when I face the outside world, I'm not, you know, uprooted quickly by things. So I was strengthening my roots when that was happening. And it is beautiful that at the same time, there were people like Ivan who were writing rooted characters, who were writing characters who needed to be played by women who know what their strength is, so to say. That way, what we do, what you do, what I do, what women do in real life will start reflecting in the screens that are written. Because after all, there is a very surreal relationship that that exists between our reality, your reality and mine, and what is seen on the screen. So while I was fortifying my strength as a human, as a woman, as an educated person, my friends immediately after graduation had chosen to educate themselves in the field of cinema. So one of my college friends, Gautam Arora, had gone to Ravi Prasad, and he was a part of the casting team for Sony. I was just done with my master's. He was done with his film education there. He was he must have been brought on board by some people for Sony, and he calls me and tells me that there's this character I want you to audition. Are you still auditioning, or have you gone back to Haryana? You know, have you left the field?
Yeah.
I was like, what happened? What will make you think so? You know, because Haryana is a space where most of my most of the girls my age, or let's say most of the women my age, I don't know how to choose the girl and woman nomenclature right now for me, looking at the frock that I'm wearing and whatever. So, most of my classmates, girls who were in my school, all of them are married. Most of them have kids. So when he said, have you gone back and started a family, or are you still here in the field? It was slightly funny. I said, shut up, tell me what you want to do. So, you know, because we're friends. So he's like, there's an audition and I think you'll nail the part. I said, all right. So that is when I got this script. I auditioned for it. I sent a self-tape. Then I got a call that the director liked the self-tape. I met him after a week. We did some improvisational rounds. After which I met the producer, which was the nail in the coffin, and we had decided. So first a self-taped audition, then a meeting with the director and assistant directors, and a round of improvisations. Then a meeting with the producer. In front of the producer also, there was a round of improvised sessions, which is Kartiki and Narayan Singh.
So that's it. By that time, they just knew that we got Sony, right?
Yeah.
I just want to say one thing. Aise matlab, abhi jab bolungi, you will be like, haan, abhi to bol rahe ho, but nahi. I want to share my experience ke jab maine Sony dekhi, I was like, she's playing like women like us, who's so angry, and you played so well. And I was like, God, like, I need to know this girl. Like, I want to know her. How can I find her? Like, I want to, like, you know, I want to work with her, you know? So that's what I'm saying. Like, it was that believable, you know? And I think, I mean, I don't know who else they auditioned. I'm sure they have auditioned some really fine actors, but I mean, you just did, you were supposed to be Sony.
So I was saying that out of some strange twist that the destiny had in store, I had read the script for Sony for some project. They had given it to some writer who happened to be my friend, and I had read the script. But then the project was taken away from the writer, And my friend told me that project is not happening. But I had read the script. And I knew that if I get a chance to play this character, I would be able to do it, you know.
Give you. Yeah.
I knew I would be.
When did you read the script then? Like the Sony script? What do you mean you read it earlier? It was supposed to be done
with someone else.
If 7th January is when I sent my self-taped audition.
Yeah.
23rd December is when I had read the script.
Okay.
With a friend who's a writer who was given the task of translating the script to Delhi Hindi. But then the project did not happen and it was taken away from him. So he said that project that I had read with you is not happening. I said, all right, but it was a nice script. And you know, his name is Rajesh. I was like, you know, Rajesh, if I get an opportunity to play Sony, I know how I'll do it. I know I'll give a real life to the character. And he just did this to me. Haan, theek hai, theek hai. You know?
And that eventually happened.
It happened. And then it came to me, I was like, I had said something. Now the universe is like, what do you say you'll do it? Do it. So I was like, okay. And thank you so much for expressing all the appreciation.
So as you were saying, after that Sony experience, unlike many other artists or many other people who would want to, you know, just, you know, go out there for, you know, better scripts, or, you know, you went somewhere else, which is the right way, I would say. Like, you were following your heart, you went studying. I mean, you wanted to do the diploma. How did the second film happen? Didn't you have any strategy at that point, or were you just waiting that, you know?
I wasn't making strategies ever. I believe in working on myself, and my sense of self-worth. Mm-hmm. I am gifted with a very solid sense of self-worth. You know, it is very heavy. Heavy in the sense it is a very thick, dense sense of self-worth that I have within me. So I believe on working on myself, my physical, spiritual, mental health, and other things that have to happen, they will happen. Most of the times I have the ability to believe it. When it starts reaching the point of being lazy, I check myself.
So coming back to that point that you came to Bombay, clearly now you knew that it's a new life, new city, you know. So how did this next film happen? Like, where, how did you decide, acha chalo mujhe ye karni hai ya phir no, I don't want to, nahi karni hai. So how did that decision come for the second film?
I was called for an audition by two of the casting. So there's a casting person. When you go to Bombay, when I went to Bombay, like I said, some people started calling me, and then there were some seniors from my college and some people who I knew previously in my life, who were brought up in Bombay. Anukampa Harsh is one of them. So I started getting in touch with them, and I said, how do I try and make sense of this place? So they would name certain casting people. So I was trying to figure something out when different things started happening. So I would be called for auditions. I would go and ask them about the project, ask them the questions which I thought were, again, my questions will even then be related to what is the character's part, what does the story say, what is the project saying, why are you making it? Mm-hmm. You know, the big existential questions, which I realized that a casting agent didn't know how to answer a question, why is someone making it? And then I realized that only when you meet a director, do you get to ask certain questions. And then I realized my questions are the kinds that only a director can answer. But before I get to be in a room with the director, there are lots of people, a team that the director works with, then teams to which the director's team outsources the projects. That those teams reach out to actors, and if I have my agency, which I had, like I had an agency managing me up till last month, I realized that there are so many teams between a director and an actor. who actually would, you know, a director has envisioned something and an actor would make it into, bring life to it along with other HODs and other things. But in Bombay, there are so many, you know, structures
that
I was like, all right, how am I going to, I know I can act. How am I going to make a sense of this? But then again, I said, look inwards. The more you look inwards, more confident you will be about what you can do. The more you look outwards, the less confident you will feel because you know very little. I decided to keep a balance of both. I still, till now, try to maintain a balance of both. Karan from Nandini Srikanth Casting Agency, he called me. He said, this is, he named the protagonist. He was like, this protagonist's made, you have to play. I said, all right, you want to audition me? Because this director's name, Anubhav Sinha, I had seen Article 15 and I had read reviews for Mulk. I knew what Mulk stood for. So I said, I respect this director's work. So I definitely would want to audition. However, I would not want to waste your time. So I want to keep, make it very clear that if the director likes my audition, if artistically they find me valuable, I would need to read the entire script before I say a yes to the project. So he said, all right, fair enough. You know, because Virat, before going for an audition, you cannot ask for the entire script always. You can't always ask for it. You have to see where do you stand in terms of your relationship with the team. Maybe for the next project, before the audition, maybe I can ask Anubhav for the entire script. But last time I couldn't. I also wanted to value their time, you know, because if they're going to audition 50 people, if everyone asks for the script, it might become chaotic for them. I said, you see, if you think I'm worth giving this much time and attention to by your people, then only I'll seek time and attention, not just like that. So I sent my version of the of Sunita, and Anubhav liked it. Then I had gone to meet, I was called to meet him, which I thought was a good opportunity. I met him and I was like, I really would want to, with all the respect for you, I want to read the script because it was something I'd made clear already. He said, yes, fair enough. In 2 hours, you'll get the script. I said, within 24 hours from having read the script, I will clarify, I will give a clear answer to if I want to be part of the script or not. So he said, all right. I thought of the kind of calculations that I could not have thought of a year ago. But then I realized that, Geetika, these are the calculations that you've never worked with. You know, this is not your forte. Look at your strengths. What are your strengths? Your instinct, your choice of stories. What is this story? What part is your story saying? And then there's a woman who's really precious to me. I mentioned Anukampa, her mother. She has great experience in terms of Bombay and Hindi cinema. I discussed with her. I called 3 of my friends, seniors who were in the film industry. Listened to the 4 of them, and then made up my mind that I wanted to be a part of it. I had some issues with the script. I could not pinpoint, but I needed to meet the director. I met the director before I could say a word. He said, we have added 2 scenes. And I was like, what are those 2 scenes? The moment he narrated those 2 scenes, my problem with the script was gone. Because the problem that I had with the script, he actually had the solution for them. And I suddenly realized that he is improving and evolving in the same direction where my problems are getting solved. So I was like, let's just do it. So we started with it. That was my journey. There are 2 films I can discuss. There are 3 films that I've been a part of. I can talk about all 3 of them up to different degrees. The first film that I was, out of the 3 films, the first film that hopefully will see the light of the day is Bara Bhai Bara. It is a film directed, written, co-produced, co-written by 2 people, that's Gaurav Madan and Sunny Lahiri. It's the first speech we found together. So Bara Bhai Bara is interestingly about the last dead photographer in the city of Banaras. Banaras is known for the cremations that happen there, which are very important to a number of believers of Hindu way of living. Mm-hmm. Now, Bara Bhai Bara has been shot on 16mm and is really close to my heart. Hopefully, that will be the first project that sees the light of the day. After which, I had shot before Thappar actually. No, after Thappar. In the month of December 2019, I had shot for this feature film, which will be a clubbing together of three stories. The director hasn't finalized the title yet because apparently the title that he pumped in has already been registered by Anubhav. So, Aman Sachdeva is the name of the director. And let's see what title he comes up with. I can say my character's name is Ashrafa, who's a career-oriented... I wouldn't even say career-oriented. Who's a girl from Lucknow who has dreams. And in order to realize her dreams, she's now here in the city of Bombay. And you'll discover what her story is like. After which, there is my fifth feature, which I was working on when the COVID struck the globe, I would say. Or I would, I might also say that the fear of COVID struck the globe, because I'm realizing somewhere COVID is real. However, what is making it fearful is the fear-mongering which has been fabricated around it, and the pathetic state the health structures are in. That the truth to the destruction caused by COVID is not actually how dangerous COVID is, but it is actually how dangerous humans are to each other when it comes to not having systematically not having valued healthcare systems, not having valued a certain class of the society.
Yeah,
that way it's a
okay.
So the film, the shooting got shut midway.
Yeah,
and it'll be a very beautiful family oriented happy story.
I know we've been planning this for quite some time, but finally it happened, because you know, and I hope you know you will like the final episode, and you know, with it will, and hopefully it'll inspire the people here as well as you know, people in your country. And anything else you want to say? This is the end of the show. I just can't thank you enough.
Thank you for reaching out to me and making this possible. As in, your energy, your intention of wanting to make this happen is actually two people connecting across national boundaries. It is, I think, a situation... the space where we are in right now, it's really important to be able to hear stories that might just make you feel like, after seeing Sony, a number of people wrote to me that looking at you on screen was like, she's one of us. So for me, every occasion where even one person can think, oh, she's like me, so if she can be there, I can be there, is a moment of personal growth for me, because to see someone to see, like I said, lagta hai life linear hai, wo life linear nahi hai. We are scattered like stars, and whoever we can pick some light from the day we are dull is something that gives all of us a chance to you know, like, okay, brighten up. So if that can happen, it will just be sweet. If anything that I've said sparks something in someone, it will be like this interview or this talk entire will be successful for me. Because for some people, my life can be full of struggles. For some people, it can look like a very blessed life. I want to say, all of us have our struggles. your shares of struggle, I have my shares of struggle, everyone has their shares of struggle. It's just that to look beyond that struggle, to have a dream beyond it, to have the faith, ability to forgive oneself and just keep on working on oneself and go ahead and get the dream, become a part of the solution. When you see a problem, start working on the solution. That's something important. Things like these are also a reminder for me. Years down the line, I would look back and see what was I saying. To some of my friends, they call me that, you know, it's good to see you saying this. If you change, I'm going to personally be calling you. And I said, it's important for me to have people who are watching out. In case I change, do reach out to me. Because I try to observe my journey, but if I get immersed and there's a change, talk to me, tell me you can see me change, and I'll either talk to you or I'll either shift my trajectory again. So yeah, it's interesting to be having things on record.
But no, thank you so much. Honestly, this was the end of the show, so we will end it here.
Amra shobai ek, cholo connected thake, internet o arte madhyame. Thank you, Sonia. I might have gone wrong in the pronunciation, but my intentions are just to say that we are all one and let's stay connected with the help of art and internet. Assalamu alaikum. All right, assalamu alaikum.